Guten Tag, wie geht's? Wie steht's noch? Immer auf zwei Beinen. Bonjour, Strasvice, ni hao ma, como va, tudo bem? Greetings, this is Greg. Once again, we're together discussing Tesla trucks. I started off my whole truck coverage after Elon Musk came out. I looked up photos of the Tesla truck, and the first thing that showed up were images of the nIkola 1 truck with Tesla on the side. So after I posted these in a thumbnail, one of my viewers made a point of contacting me and suggested that he was asking why it was that I was using a nIkola 1 as my picture truck. And I explained to him that it was what I had found online. And on further reading, there are all the signals that the nIkola 1, the lithium-ion batteries being used in that vehicle, are actually the Tesla-produced batteries. So there are several items there. Number one, I've driven the distance between Salt Lake City and where the Tesla factory is in Reno. And at 125 miles an hour, it's only 3 hours. So it's a perfect location for the two companies to get together. So I doubt very highly if there would be any other battery packs in the nIkola vehicle other than the Tesla batteries that are coming from the supercharger plant in Reno. So that was a second clue. A third clue is the fact that nIkola originally was going to use lithium-ion battery pack along with natural gas, and they then changed that to an electric chassis with a nitrogen fuel to cover the nitrogen helping to regenerate the batteries and giving the vehicle a 1,200 mile range. This is an interesting choice by Tesla to go this route. They could have just built the vehicle themselves, but by partnering with an outside company, all the development and so forth can really be outsourced. And they're getting 50 to 70% of the sale anyway because of their batteries being such a large component of the costs for this truck. So I've decided to attach, you'll see above my screen here, a mention and some video of the nIkola vehicle. And this is nIkola as in Nikola Tesla. So the name even fits. So I'm pretty confident that when we announce in September, you'll be satisfied with the correlation between the two organizations. So the next thing I'd like to cover is the fact that one of the other challenges that they're having with the battery packs only, or electric battery packs only, is that you're facing some real difficulties. One of the most important routes in the United States is Los Angeles out of that port and then to Houston or to San Francisco. And at least in the San Francisco direction north, there's a huge amount of mountains there. So you could probably use up 200 miles of normal battery life in just going 50 miles of mountains. So I could definitely see why they're making the decision to look at combining with either those, you know, if it's a truly long distance Class A truck, usually going above 250 miles, you know, if there's a mileage challenge, you definitely have to address that. So another variable in terms of the consideration is the changing sort of temperature impact on all electric batteries in terms of the chemical reaction. So one of the challenges that pops up is below freezing, in essence, you kind of roll into about half the battery life. The chemical reaction that goes on cuts your battery life in half. So if you've got established truck routes and you're trying to run those with electric only, there are a lot of what-ifs that have to be taken into mind. And unlike short routes, you don't have the ability to recover quickly by stopping at a supercharger station. It's a much more challenging circumstance. So I think this is actually a smart partnership and a smart move. I think it gets Tesla a good partnership that serves both sides well, and it's an easy supply chain access from Reno to Salt Lake City, where the headquarters of nIkola are located. I'll be intrigued to see also, you know, I have to admit I'm very surprised by this partnership, because Tesla is partnered with Mercedes-Benz in the medium and light duty department. And, you know, at this point, Mercedes is rolling out their light duty trucks in the form of Fuso and other under the Mercedes brand to other places. When it comes to medium duty truck, Mercedes is a year into testing with the Tesla battery packs. And I expect that they'll soon be past the test phase and start actually selling those trucks after their 1 year test is over, latter part of 2017. But when it comes to heavy duty trucks, there are a lot of issues that have to be worked out. And I think that can be done in this case and done effectively. So I think that's, you know, the general take I have on it right now when it comes to Tesla. And I want to thank you for taking time out to view. I'm going to take you out once again with a view around what's here. Merci beaucoup. Danke schön. Tschüss, max gut. Au revoir. La hitraut. Choda hafez. Please like and subscribe.